All you need to fold this model is a square of paper. It can be really any square. I've got some paper here that's called commie paper. It's a bit lightweight and it's color on one side and white on the other, just so you can see what I'm doing. But you can fold this out of copy paper, really any kind of paper. So to get started, we're going to take the square and we're going to fold a diagonal into the square, just like that. And for this model, you want to make your creases pretty sharp. It'll help you out in the end. All right, so you're going to open that. Then you're going to turn your paper so that you can fold the other diagonal. As you know, squares have two diagonals, and we're going to make folds on both of them. Okay. When you open your paper, you're going to see that you have folds here and folds here. And what I like to do at this point, right now we folded it this way, which we call a valley fold. It's like a valley here. But I'm going to turn the paper over and I'm going to make my fold go the other way. And I'm going to do the same thing on the second diagonal. So it went this way originally. You're going to make it go this way. We call that a fold that has no direction. It likes to go back and forth easily either way. We're going to need that later. Okay. What we're going to do now is we're going to focus on this quadrant, this one quarter section right here of the paper, and we're going to fan fold this section just up to these diagonals. We don't want our folds going all the way out to the edge, just to here. So I'll show you how to do that. You're going to take this edge and you're going to bring it all the way to the center where the diagonals cross. Line up your edges nicely over here so that you know this band is got two parallel edges. And you're going to make a crease just over here to the diagonal. When I open it up, I see my crease just goes from here to here. And I have folded this distance in half. I'm going to take the edge again and fold it right up to the crease that I just made. Very nicely lined up right along that crease so that, again, we get two parallel edges. And I'm going to crease it along here only to the diagonal, and same here. And now I have divided this section in half, or you might say I've divided this entire section into one quarter, two quarters, but we need to divide the rest of it into the last three and fourth quarter. And to do that, I'm going to take my paper, turn it over. See, this looks like a mountain here now. And I'm going to just pleat it up. I'm going to bring it all the way up to the center. But don't fold yet. All I'm going to do is make a little pinch mark right here. You can feel that there's a layer of paper under there. I'm going to mark that. And when I turn it over, I see I have a crease here, but it's not going the way I want it to go. I want it to be a valley like these two. So I'm going to carefully take my paper and reverse that fold right on that same pinch line, only to the diagonals. So when you fold this model, it's a good thing to say to yourself when you're folding these quadrants to say, I'm only folding to the diagonal. So just tell yourself that, because we're going to repeat this eventually around the whole model. For now, though, I'm going to turn my paper back over because I've got mountain folds here. They were valley folds on the other side. And I want Now I've got mountains, I turn them over. I want valley folds in between so that I can fold it up like a fan, back and forth, okay? So I'm going to take this edge and fold it to the first crease. Okay, again, only to the diagonal. You can see the diagonal fold sticking up here. So now I have valley, mountain. Excellent. I'm going to take this again and fold this, sort of pinching it, making like a pleat here, and I'm folding it to the next mountain fold, only to the diagonal. Sometimes it helps to look at the other side and check it out, okay, but you'll get the hang of it. I'm going to pleat up the next mountain fold and take it to the following one, only to the diagonal. Sometimes it goes a little over, not a big deal, just try not to. And finally I'm going to take the final mountain fold and bring it up to the middle. That is where the two diagonals cross. And if you fold it all the way to the diagonal you see here, it's going to go too far. So just sort of guesstimate where that little diagonal might be. If you want to, after you're done with that, you can look here, fold it over on the valley fold, and you can clearly see where the diagonal is. That's a little bit easier. So now I've got valley, mountain, valley, mountain, valley, mountain, valley. That's what I want for this one quarter of the paper. Okay. And here I have marked those folds so you can see them better and understand what you're going to want. I marked it on the white side of the paper. It's a little easier to see. So now this, what I call the valley on the other side, became a mountain. Mountain, valley, mountain, valley, mountain, valley, mountain. The important thing is that they alternate. And you can kind of see what I'm talking about if I start gathering them up. I can fan fold it back and forth just to show you the idea, etc. So we're not going to fold it yet though, because we need to do this here, 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 as well as where we started. So I'm just going to show you a little bit of this process, because you're going to connect up the folds. So where you see, let's start on the white side. Where you see, let's see, we started in the middle, right? When we brought this edge to the middle, we made a fold just to the diagonal, and it was a valley fold on the white side, and it connects up perfectly with this valley fold. Then we brought the edge to that fold, made valley fold just to the diagonals, connects up perfectly to this valley fold. And then if you remember, we did this little process where we turned the paper over. We took this mountain fold, pinched it up, brought it to the middle, and just made a little mark. And then we turned the paper back over. And now it's going in the wrong direction because it's a mountain fold. So we're just going to reverse that. Perfect. Matches up perfectly. Now, we're going to turn the paper over. We've got mountain folds now, and we're going to bring the edge to the first mountain fold. We're going to just fold to the diagonal crease, and it matches up perfectly with this valley fold. We'll pleat this up and take it to the next mountain fold. line. And if we didn't get it exactly right, we can turn the paper over and we see we didn't quite get to the diagonal, so I'm just going to pinch that a little further along. Okay. Next mountain fold up here. The following mountain. So we've got this valley matching that valley, and we've got one more. This one doesn't have a little partner here, so we're gonna fix that right now. And there we've got our folds here in this quadrant, and now we've got the folds that all turned the corner and went to this quadrant. And we're going to keep going. And when we finish, we're going to have this. This has all of our folds. And I've marked them now so that you can see clearly the mountain fold, the valley, mountain, valley, mountain. And they have to match. So if there's a valley here, it has to turn the corner and stay a valley, stay a valley, stay a valley. So you can see that we've got a series of concentric squares. That means the center of the squares are all in the same place, but they get bigger and bigger and bigger in exactly the same amount. That's all the folding for this model. But you see, it doesn't look quite like this yet. So we have to help it along a little bit. What we're going to do is we're going to start pleating the model by folding, say, start on the outside, and we have a mountain fold here and a mountain fold here, and we're going to start making it go into its mountain shape. Then we've got a valley fold, so now we're going to pleat that up so that it becomes a valley. We're going to kind of do that little by little all the way around. Can't really do this model all at once. You have to kind of do all the parts around the center and then work your way in toward the middle. And I'll explain that the reason we wanted the diagonals to go both ways is if you look carefully, you'll see that the diagonal here is a valley, but when it comes up to this ring, it's a mountain. Then it's going to be a valley. Then it's going to be a mountain. So we really need for it to be able to be happy either way. And that's why we did that back and forth on the diagonal to begin with. And you can see that we're just encouraging it to go in. This little plateau in the middle is getting smaller and smaller because we're pleating it. And until we get into the middle. And you could put another ring of squares. I guess it'd be pretty small in this one. You probably don't want to do that, but you're going to end up with a little square in the middle. Okay. Now, I will say this doesn't quite look like this yet. So what do we need to do? We're going to grab the model and we're going to pull down a little bit on these two, what you could call legs. Doesn't matter which two, they just have to be across from each other. And when you do that, the other two, I want this little bar in the middle here. The other two are going to go up. So these go down and these go up. And you really cannot, once you're pulling these down, you can't also pull these down. Although I'll show you that if I wanted those down instead, I could pull those down instead. It doesn't matter which two, but the other two are going to go up. And now it's sort of ready to just kind of spread out a little bit here. So you want to be able to see those pleats. And that's how it ends up. Now I will show you one more thing, because there's no limit on how close together these pleats can be. As I said, it's a model for a smooth surface. So the closer together you put the pleats, the more sort of smooth it gets, you might say. So I've made another model. This has twice as many pleats, whereas this is a pleat here and a pleat down in there. This one has pleats halfway along every one of these bands, so twice as many. So it's starting to look a little smoother. And you could put, if you were very patient, twice as many as this one has, and it would get even more smooth looking. And just one other fun thing I'll show you. I showed you about the legs going down and the legs going up, and if you decide you want to switch them around, you can, even in this position, you can pull this down and the other two go up. Sometimes you have to kind of resituate the pleats a little bit. Some people like to play with them and go back and forth. It's kind of fun to see how that happens. So that's the hyperbolic paraboloid.